Good evening, my dear students. Now we discuss about the hypolipidemics. So hypolipidemics means in here these hypolipidemics drugs are. So hypolipidemics means decreases the lipid level in our body. Decreases the lipid level in our body is known as hypolipidemics. Hypolipidemics drugs are the drugs are which lower the level of lowers the level of lipids and as well as the lipoproteins. Lipids and lipoproteins are lower level of lipids and lipoproteins is known as hypolipidemics. So where it is located? In the blood. So hypolipidemics means these drugs are which lower level of lipids or lipoproteins in a blood is known as hypolipidemics. So first of all, what is the lipid? It is a free fatty acid and presented in the blood. So the lipids are the soluble in alcohol and insoluble in water. And the lipids are stored in the body. Which purpose? It is the purpose of the energy reservoir. And the next one, different types of lipids are presented. What is the example? Example is cholesterol, fat substances, and etc. triglycerides, and etc. These are all are the example for the lipids. So what is the serum lipids? What is the serum lipids normal value? So 400 to 800 mg per deciliter. This is the normal value of serum lipids. This is the normal value of serum lipids. In case of decreases, this value is known as hypolipidemics. In case of increases, this one value is known as a hyperlipidemics. So what about the lipoproteins? So lipoproteins are the, lipoproteins means lipids plus proteins is known as lipoproteins. Lipids containing the proteins is known as lipoproteins. And the next one, these are synthesized in the liver. And it contains the different amount of, the lipoproteins containing the different amount of triglycerols, cholesterol, and etc. So it depends upon the different amount. Lipoproteins are classified into several types. What are their lipoproteins? Low density lipoproteins, high density lipoproteins, very low density lipoproteins, very low density, and chaperones. So these are the lipoproteins. Low density, high density, very low density lipoproteins are there. So depends. This is the classification. So depends upon the density. So it divided into only three types: low density, high density, very low density. So this is about the lipoproteins. The hypolipidemic drugs are play a important role in the treatment of these drugs. So the hypolipidemic drugs are, what is the importance of hypolipidemic drugs? It is a prevention of the cardiac diseases. Cardiac means CVS disorders. Treatment in the CVS disorders. All are the prevented by this particular hypolipidemic disease. So which type of disease? It is accelerated in the atherosclerosis and then hyperlipidemics. Hyperlipidemic diseases all are the treated by this particular hypolipidemics. And the next one, what is the classification of the drugs? Classification. It classified into several types. Number one type, first one type is the HMG-CoA drugs. What is the abbreviation of HMG? HMC means it is a hydroxy. It is HMG means hydroxy methyl glutaryl coenzyme A. Hydroxy methyl glutaryl coenzyme A. What is the coenzyme A? It is a reductase inhibitors. HMG-CoA reductase inhibitors is an example. So in here, in this, what are the examples? Examples in here, number one, lovastatin, and in number two, simvastatin, and the next one, number three, atorvastatin. These are all are the example for the HMG-CoA. And the second is the bile acid suppressants. Sequestrants. This is also called as the resins. Example. Cholesteramine and Cholestipol. And number three classification is fibric acid derivatives. So what are their fibric acid derivatives? So fibric acid derivatives is number one, clofibrate. Number two, phenofibrate. And number three, gemfibrozil. These are examples of the fibric acid. So this is the classification of the hypolipidemic drugs. So the hypolipidemic drugs we are discussing about them now, discussing about the HMG-CoA drugs. So HMG-CoA drug is one is lovastatin. So the lovastatin, what is the lovastatin? So it is used as a cholesterol lowering agent. It is act as a cholesterol lowering agent. And the next one, what is the mechanism action of this particular HMG-CoA? What is the mechanism of action? So it is a mechanism of action. The lovastatin inhibition of hydroxymethylglutaryl coenzyme A. So it one is inhibition of the HMG-CoA. So HMG-CoA is inhibited. It leads to the decreasing the cholesterol level. So the HMG-CoA is inhibited by the lovastatin, and as well as the reducts the enzyme and a reductase enzyme. Reduced synthesis of cholesterol. So reduce the synthesis of cholesterol, and as well as the reduce the enzyme activity. Which enzyme? HMG-CoA. Without HMG-CoA, there is no chance for the production of this particular cholesterol in the body. So this is about the mechanism of action. And the next one, what is the dose? This dose is it administered through oral administration. This adult dose is the 20 mg daily per day. 20 mg 20 mg. Sometimes it divided into 20 to 80 mg depends upon the disease status. 20 and it is divided into only within one dose only per day, one dose only. So this is the adult dose. And the next one, what is the children dose? What is the children dose? Per day 15 mg, depends upon the disease status, 15 to 50 mg per day. It is administered through orally per day, only one dose. This is about the dose. And the next one, what is the contraindications? Contraindications. So hypersensitivity, pregnancy, lactation, and liver diseases. And the next one, in here produces the electrolyte imbalance, also produces in children. It produces the visual disorders. In children, visual disorders are produces. This is about the contraindications of this particular hypolipidemic drugs. And what is the side effects of this particular drug? What is the side effects? So in here, muscle cramps occur. And the next one, it produces skin rash and headache is observed, and headache, nausea, heartburn is occur. And the next one, blurred vision occur. This is the side effects. The next one, what is the pharmacokinetics? So pharmacokinetics. So it is the, these are drug are the admitted, this drug are administrated through orally. These are drug are administrated through orally. And the next one, this drug is distributed through body fluids and blood. And the next one, the drug is metabolized. There is no metabolism. Why? Because of it is already metabolized drug. And the next one, this drug is excreted through as a urine. And the next one, what is the half-life of this drug? So this half-life of this drug is a 4 to 5 hours. So this is about this particular pharmacokinetics of this drug. And the next one, what is the role of nurse? So role of nurse is the first of all to monitoring the cholesterol level during the treatment. And the next one, to advise the patient to take cholesterol lowering diet. To take low cholesterol diet. And the next one, to assess the intake and output ratio. And the next one, and study the blood nitrogen and blood creatinine. These are all are studied. And the next one, this medicine only administered with the breakfast or evening meal. So to advise the patient take a medicine or dose, so with the meal, evening meal, or with breakfast, after completion of the breakfast only. And the next one, to evaluate the drug response. So this is about the role of nurse. If you have any doubts from this topic, tomorrow we will discuss. Thank you.